Environmental health is always global. It's not a regional problem. And the WHO estimates that up to 25% of the overall global burden of disease is attributable to environmental risks. Of course, there are differences between countries, but the range of impact is considerable in public health. And facing problems that we are facing now with COVID-19, you can imagine how important it is to work on issues that would make matters worse. So there is one positive thing is that there is always the potential to disease prevention and public health protection that we know have been achieved in many developed countries, but it's still to be realized in developing countries. So outside of the current problems we are facing now, there is this background problem that we have to deal with. We have a network of collaborating centers that supports the implementation of PAHO WHO programs on environmental health. And they play a key role in this process, not only by disseminating the information from WHO and PAHO, but also by creating knowledge and scientific evidence and by helping to develop effective interventions that would change the risks. By doing so, the collaborating centers not only strengthen the capacity of PAHO to develop its agenda of work of WHO as well, but also to move forward on solving problems that come into place. We're very proud of the work developed by our network of collaborating centers on environmental health, and they support effectively the unity of climate change and environmental health at the CDE department at PAHO. And we know that they have been partners of PAHO for many years, and we share common interests and goals in understanding the linkages between the environment and health in order to prevent disease, improve human health, and promote environmental sustainability. The challenges that we face are huge. But there is one reason to find some comfort in that we can count on the support of the collaborating centers. There are many of them, and they have done work with us. I wouldn't have time to talk about all of them, but I would like to make some highlights of the centers in the past 2 years. I would say that, for instance, the Vice Presidency on Environmental Health Services of the Oswaldo Cruz Foundation, Fiocruz, is a center that has been crucial to the development of methodologies on environmental health in the region. There are many products I could name, but I would like to mention two of them that are that has been developed recently or is in development. The first is on the implementation of the resolution presented at the World Health Assembly, the 72 World Health Assembly, and the construction of a roadmap to achieve the 8 steps of the Global Water 2020. By developing a project on monitoring the improvements in water sanitation and hygiene and health facilities, healthcare facilities. And this has been done in 10 selected countries in collaboration with ITRAS, our regional technical team on water and sanitation that is based in Peru. And with this 10 countries, the reports were published and recommendations was done for the implementation of these steps based on the WHO agenda. resolution. And the second is an initiative to respond to the emergency of COVID-19. And it's a project that's going on right now to summarize the evidence, organize a regional network of research groups, and prepare a technical guidance document on the use of surveillance of SARS-2 COVID-19 in wastewaters to support decision making on the pandemic and surveillance of COVID-19 in the region. And there are more than 40 researchers involved in this project from more than 10 countries that are working on and under the leadership of the Collaborating Center in collaboration with the work of PAHO. So I think this is, we can say it's crucial for our work. But there are some others, and I would mention the Dirección de Salud Ambiental del Instituto Nacional de Salud Pública in Mexico. And this center is basically specialized in training in environmental epidemiology and has helped PAHO with the elaboration and the organization of an online course on environmental epidemiology to support capacity building of healthcare workers to deal with environmental health issues. This course has recently been updated with the collaboration of other centers, but coordinated by this Collaborating Center, and is now available in the virtual campus. It has more than 9,000 students already, so, and most of them from the region and people working in the public sector. So it has supported the development and translation of tools provided by WHO, also translated to Spanish, and training people. Previously, the training were done in person, in vivo, and nowadays online, like many of our activities. But it also supported the development of the evidence that we needed for the elimination of the use of solid fuels for cooking in the region. The center has also updated our database on air pollution in cities in the Americas, which we use for indicators of our strategic plan. So it's a very active and important center for us. There are many other products as well. The other center that is in Mexico is the one on the División de Estudios Superiores para la Equidad, Facultad de Medicina de la Universidad Autónoma de San Luis Potosí. This center supports much of the work done on children's environmental health in the region, but also globally. Among the products they are developing is the work done on waste, electronic waste, and children's health. And we have a project that is funded by UNIDO and the Jeff Global Environmental Fund through UNIDO to PAHO. And this project is initially implemented in Panama and Bolivia. And this center is helping us to produce materials for training and is developing an online course that will help to develop capacity for to identify risks, to manage risks, and to provide means to avoid these risks for children and their families in the region. Another center that is very active and very supportive of our work is the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences, NIHS, from the US. that assist in promoting cooperation among environmental health research institutes and among other things. And I would mention two activities that were done, and they were included in our 4 years work plan, and they were already implemented. One was in developing a network to strengthen the evidence for the implementation of the WHO indoor air quality guidelines, and particularly in the Americas. And the center has supported the organization of a regional workshop that was held in Mexico, where representatives of ministries of health, ministries of energy and environment, technical people of the most affected countries proposed to work towards the elimination of the use of solid fuels for cooking by 2030, which is now part of the PAHO disease elimination initiative. So it's a very, I think it's a goal achieved with the collaboration, and they remain working with us in this initiative. Another highlight was the contribution to accelerate the research on CKDU, the chronic kidney disease of unknown etiology. This is a disease that is a heavy burden in Central America countries, but also in other regions of the world. So this activity was co-organized with the international network of researchers, SENCAM network, but also together with the other region of WHO, SEARU, that has shares the same problems in some of the countries. And they helped to organize the workshop and connected different research institutions of the affected countries, not only in Central America, but also in Asia and some in Africa. The report of this workshop has been published by NIHS, and NIHS has also funded participation of researchers from developing countries, and helped to open a research line through NIH that now deals specifically with the issue to expand the knowledge of the problem, which helped to increase the research on this priority topic for the Americas. So I think there are others, and they are related to the WHO work, but I thought this one showed clearly how important the center is for environmental health in the region. The other centers, I would mention, they always are ready to respond to needs. And there is one on toxicology. It's the Department of Toxicology of the Faculty of Medicine, the Universidad de la República Oriental de Uruguay. This center is very active on children's environmental health as well, but responds to all needs we have in toxicology. And I would highlight the important support for the response of COVID-19 by collaborating with PAHO in the elaboration of documents, technical documents, and promoting discussions and webinars regarding the use of disinfectants and the risks regarding to it, and how to properly use the chemicals, and including the response and the on the use of chlorine products as medication, debunking false and fake messages about its therapeutic uses. So I could expand on this from all the centers, but I believe I provided a clear view of how much we need and how much of support we have from the centers for the area of environmental health and climate change in the region. The impact is enormous if you think that we would never achieve, having access to multiple stakeholders require work done almost daily. And if we did only with the people working at PAHO on environmental health, we would never be able to achieve all these goals and having all the targets we had. And so the impact the centers have on our work and on support, in supporting PAHO's work, is their capacity of reaching out for different stakeholders, on bringing together forces, societal forces that help support the agenda, but also think forward and in the formulation of the problems and the solutions we may need to work with. And in many cases, the centers work not only directly with us, but they are very influential in their own capacity in their countries. So it's a way of supporting and triangulation, I would say, even the activities we have with our member states. And in many cases, even beyond the activities already agreed upon, we have always an activity that is meant to be used in, by PAHO's request. And this has been broadly used in all these years. So I would say to respond to emergencies, to respond to problems new problems we're facing, and to develop methodologies that we need to implement our work plans.